So the question is, why doesn't he grow up? Why does he still behave as a child? How can we help him get rid of these leftovers from childish behavior?
Everyone seems to act childish sometimes, but I don't understand just why.
Different parts of our personalities grow at different rates.
So one side of a fellow's personality could be grown up, and another still infantile.
What we need is some method of measuring our growth.
You smell that? There's a woman here.
Yeah. Oh my God, we got a girl here.
Oh my God, we got a woman here, Sasha Merci. Is that your real name?
Yeah, it is.
You promise?
Yes, I promise.
Because it sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
Like a little too good.
Well, it's funny because my mom really put a lot of thought in our names. So my oldest brother's name, his name is James Nicole.
No.
Gutierrez.
Does right? he tell everybody that his middle name is Nicole?
Yes, he does. He actually does. He calls himself Nick, right? Because I think it was one of her favorite writers or something. And then my sister... her name, my mom really loved Bruce Lee. There was a time when she really loved him.
Really?
Yeah. So she named my sister Jennifer Lee.
Neat.
Gutierrez. Right.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, the only thing that it's like, you'll know that we're Spanish is because of our last names.
Yeah.
It's like very Spanish.
Well, you would think you're Asian.
Yeah. You would think that my
exactly. your sister.
So my,
right?
yeah. So my sister's middle name is Lee.
Your mom's obsessed with Bruce Lee.
She was.
That's not a common thing I've ever heard before.
Yeah.
And she I've never heard anybody say, like, to me.
Like a woman.
My mom's obsessed with Bruce Lee.
Bruce Lee.
You got to give me 5 minutes to get my podcast mind
Titty
turned on because I'll be, like, just talking. Yeah. Been smoking way too much weed this week.
Yeah.
Bruce Lee.
Yes. So... Yeah, and then my name is Sasha Merci.
Sasha, I watched about, I don't know, 4 hours of your Instagram videos yesterday.
Really? Are you, in fact, a prisoner of love?
You are either...
I am a prisoner of love.
Weird.
No.
Sorry.
Insanely crazy. Or you're very talented, and you should be a stand-up comic.
Well, it's funny.
Because you're doing bits.
Yeah. Well, it's funny because I've never saw myself like as a comedian. The thing is that me and my brothers always got together and we'll just like make jokes after jokes after jokes. My dad is really funny. My brothers are really funny. So we grew up just making fun of each other. Or if something drastic, really bad happened, we knew how to make a joke about it. So I grew up in that. So
it's a very rare breed over here. Pretty girl that's funny. Explain
like
yourself.
Genuinely funny. Because yeah. There's a lot of pretty girls that get into stand-up who are just not funny. And no one said anything to them because they got really nice boobs or something.
It works.
For a while until you actually have to
no,
be funny.
No, it works. I went to a comedy show a couple weeks ago with Joe Larson, and there was
Shout out Joe.
There was one pretty girl that came up on stage, and like she came up, and I automatically was like,
"You were gushing."
And then
Dick, you're the problem.
After like a minute of listening to it, I was like, "Oh, this isn't funny at all."
Yeah, like she's pretty.
But it works.
She's
it
so
works.
Pretty.
It does work.
Yeah. What do you think about that? Do women get extra automatic points because they're pretty?
Well, this is horrible for me to say. But I don't
She's
think
about
women
to say
are funny.
Horrible.
I don't
Whoa.
Think.
Whoa.
Yeah, there's a lot of stand-up comedians that I'm just like, I just need to change this.
Wow. Like, well, there's some. Come
there's
on.
Some. Yeah, there's
Who
some.
Would you
there's
say
like,
is funny?
I like Lisa Lampanelli is really funny.
That pitch is crazy.
She's
yeah.
funny because she gets
she
to
funny.
The. You know what it is that women comedian. I don't know. It's just I like Lisa Lampanelli because she was like right on the money. Like,
well, she says it as it is.
Exactly.
She's honest.
She's not
yeah, and a lot of women comedians are just like, they talk about things that they think other women want to hear and that men don't understand. So yeah. It's like when they're talking about like their periods and stuff.
What's
it's just
a period?
Like, I don't want to hear it, you know. But it's very, yeah, it's very.
It's true.
It's very.
I immediately want to redirect away from talking
really?
About periods.
Yeah. I think it's, I mean,
really? Periods?
It's weird. You don't, it's not something you'd ever want to talk about.
It's just
no.
like.
It's. Why not? It's like a weird
it
thing.
It should just be at the I end of the sentence.
Look, I have a hemorrhoid.
Period.
Right, meow?
I don't want to talk about it.
All right, well, you brought it up.
Well, yeah.
Let's just not talk about it,
I don't
period.
Want to talk about it.
Let's just not talk about it, period.
Period.
That's it.
Probably is pretty funny, though. There's some angles in there.
Period? Okay.
Anyway.
But, all right, let me... I don't think a lot of women comedians are funny. Because it's
they
true.
Aren't.
It's true. You see them as a pretty girl and stuff like that, and I'm just, like, rooting for her, like, make me laugh, just make me laugh.
Is it that like, they're not funny or that just not enough women are encouraged to do stand-up?
That's
is it
also
a numbers
true.
Thing? Because there's a lot of dudes.
It's also
and there's
true.
A lot of not funny dudes.
It's also true. I think it's because women choose. Like, I meet a lot of funny women in my everyday life that are just, like, hilarious. But they choose to be either pretty or funny. Because it's like, if you're funny, you're a clown. You know what I mean? And if you're pretty, everyone wants you. So it's like...
Well, do you think it's an effect of growing up pretty? That you never have to develop that comedy? I always think that the funniest people are usually like fat guys or like fat ugly dudes because they have to develop that. They don't have any other skill to, or they don't have any other sort of aspect that just draws people to them. So they have to develop it.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was the first thing you see in anybody? Anyone, period. You just look at someone, if they're not aesthetically pleasing, already have a ding on them. You already got a ding. You're not aesthetically pleasing. So you got
to
develop good character traits. Like
you
a fat
figure
dude.
Out
if you're
something.
A fat dude and you're not very cool, like, you better be really cool, man. Because
yeah.
for whatever reason, I'm not saying it's right, but most of the time people will not want to
right.
be around you.
So I if think. You're born a very pretty girl, you basically have a handicap because you have no need or desire or there's no necessity to develop a sense of humor. You don't have to.
Well,
you can totally get by just on your looks.
Well, thank God I wasn't born a pretty girl.
Yeah?
Yeah, I wasn't. I was the ugly duckling.
Really?
Yeah, I was getting picked on all the time.
Are you one of those like, pretty really? Girls that say that?
Wait, when
no, no.
when did you get pretty then? So you're 24.
Uh-huh.
When did it switch?
It just happened. I don't know. I honestly, I don't, like, even to this day, it's just like, oh, you're pretty. I'm like, thank
calling
you.
Calling tomfoolery.
It's thank you. But, you know, I think that can also be a, like, if your people consider you, like, way too pretty, I think that's also a handicap. Because it's like, just don't talk.
It is,
for sure.
And it's like, true. It's a complete handicap because it's like, you know, they just think
but
about.
Then they don't talk. And then they don't think. And then they never have to develop anything but.
Yeah,
their looks.
So that's a thing too because it's like when I'm around guys, that's why I'm so happy I grew up with six guys. It's like my two cousins and my four brothers. So I grew up with them, and they never made me feel like an outcast.
Yeah.
So it was always like you got a joke, say it, you know. Mm-hmm. And so it was very encouraging. And if I made them laugh, then I knew I was funny.
Yeah, growing up with a bunch of dudes will make you fucking hilarious or hate yourself. It's one or the other.
Or both.
Or both for sure. If you're really funny, you'll have both.
Yeah.
But
yeah, I'm
growing
like,
up with brothers could be vicious.
Yeah, I'm like the baby too. So my oldest brother like would always see me as like his first like daughter because he's like you're the baby. So he was always.
What's the age gap?
He's 37.
Okay.
And I'm 24.
Gotcha. I can do math, so whatever.
I just. That's funny because I suck at math.
Yeah, no, I didn't want to do that.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, that's a big number.
I can't even tell you how old he was when I was born because I'll just be like, 9? I don't know. I was just raised around that. So.
It's like in high school, did you start getting pretty? Start getting attention from guys?
I guess.
Sort
I
of?
Don't remember.
College?
I just don't remember when it happened.
Wow.
I just don't remember. Maybe in high school.
Yeah.
Because I was such a tomboy, too. I was just such a tomboy. I was just like, I just felt like a guy.
Yeah,
know?
Well, you were raised with guys, right?
Yeah, so I was such a tomboy, and I wasn't really boy crazy or anything like that. So if a guy said I was pretty, I'd be like, oh, shut up. Yeah, okay. You know, so I wasn't. So maybe when I graduated high school and I just started getting into, like, getting my hair done and, like, putting on makeup and stuff like that, but
I'll tell you what, looking at your Instagram feed, My initial thought was, I'm terrified of this woman.
Really?
Yep. Yep. Because you're very pretty. And when, what happens when women get really pretty, it becomes a weapon. And it can be used for good or evil. You don't know how they're going to use it.
I jerked off three times before I got here. Should avoid that.
Well, we're weak. We're weak individuals as men. Yeah. Like, just admit it. We are. You know? So there's a very powerful weapon that pretty girls have over our weak asses. And they can use it for good or bad. And you just, you don't know. So every time I see a girl that's like very pretty, I'm like, okay, I'm going to keep you from arm's length away here because I don't know what you're capable of. I don't know who you are. It's like somebody walking around with an AK-47 on their back.
A ticking bomb.
It's just like, I'm gonna stay on this side of the street.
Get you in trouble.
You just don't know.
Well, you know my plan now. Yeah. So I must kill both of you.
So would you say that you use that weapon for good or evil? Or both?
I don't think it's a weapon. Well, really? It's not that. I just want to break the... I kind of want to break that social barrier of women... I want to make being funny sexy, or not make it, but it's just like,
I think it already is.
Yeah, it makes people way better looking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, totally. It does. It does.
It's fact.
But it's just like, I'm, you know, like I said, pretty girls, they choose like, okay, I'm just going to be pretty. I'm not going to talk, especially if like they're going on dates and they're just like, I'm just not going to say anything. I'm just going to eat this little salad.
That sounds like a terrible date.
Like, crunch it on it. You know, like it's just, you don't want to be.
You know what's terrifying about that too, though? It's this awesome weapon, but then, like, after 40, just gets
shit
a
goes
little
away,
bit
son.
Less effective every year. You know, the weapon just starts to go away.
Wait, what weapon are we talking about?
Sexiness. Attractiveness.
Yes, the
attractiveness. If you've only invested
so like,
in...
if you go all in and your looks, you're going to lose it. We're all going to lose it.
If I had to bet...
We're all going to get old. It's going to happen. Yeah. We're not going to be in our 20s forever.
Yeah, if I had to put money on it, I'm willing to bet that 1970s Miss America probably isn't the best conversationalist. If I had to put money on it.
Well, yeah, and you see some
older woman now.
You see some of them go so deep into the plastic surgery too, that where it just gets really messy.
And
yeah,
then once
really
they give up on themselves, they get on that toddler and tiara show.
Who's that?
Yeah.
Who's that?
And they work on their kids.
I just want to age gracefully, you know.
What does that mean?
Just to age gracefully, you know, healthy, and I don't want to.
You want to go out hard in a ball of fire and liquid cocaine in your blood? You don't want any of that?
No, not any of that.
All right, that's fair.
No, but yeah, because it's. It's true. Like, I mean, and women especially, they are just like, they feel that that's the, like you said, it's a weapon. It's the only thing that they have. And
what's a tool? I shouldn't call it a weapon.
Yeah.
It's a tool.
Yeah. Dudes like, use it too. It's like a hammer. Just not as much.
You can build a house or you could break somebody's face.
It's true.
You know, whatever you're going to do is up to you.
So how did you go from just being that, you know, that chick that people kind of sort of talked to in high school? I mean, you're a singer, right? I'm assuming you were always singing.
Yeah, I was always doing talent shows.
Okay. So how'd you get into that from like singing into bits? Because you're pretty fucking funny. Like, if you were to string together maybe 30 of your Instagram videos and make a cohesive 5-minute bit, pretty solid material.
I'm thinking about doing that.
Good. You already have it written.
Yeah. Well, the thing is that I just picked up my phone one day and I was just like, you know what, let me just do this. And I did it and people liked it. Like, immediately I just got texts from people and these comments, and they're just like, oh my god, like, you're so funny. But people would tell me that all the time, like, maybe you should do stand-up, but I can never picture myself doing it. And I never really got it. Like, I was like, really, you think I'm funny? But then I just started doing videos, and just, that's just how I am. Sometimes I'll say something and people will laugh and I'm like, what did I just say?
Do you watch it and go over it and think, was that good? Was that bad?
Well, now
I do.
Because now there's pressure.
Now there's pressure. Yeah, now I do.
Do you like watching yourself?
Sometimes. Because sometimes I can really make myself laugh. Like, if I do a video and I look at it and I'm like cracking up, I'm like, okay, it's worth putting up because I made myself laugh. And I think that's the first thing. If you see yourself doing it, or if you believe in yourself, then maybe you should just go for it. It's like, you have to convince yourself that you're good enough. You know what I mean? Because it's like, there's no way you can be a comedian, or there's no way you can be an actor if you're not, like, especially, like, if you're acting and stuff like that, or if you're going to go on stage. You have, the mirror is your best friend. So you have to convince yourself in the mirror that, okay, I can see myself doing this, or I can see myself on Jimmy Fallon or something. You know, just...
Totally. I think you have to overcome whatever issues you have with watching yourself.
Yeah.
If you're watching yourself and you can't stand it, there's a reason. You're probably seeing something that you're doing that you're not, you don't like.
It's like all the time, like, God, I hate listening.
It's like anything else. Like, once you identify something you want to improve on, then you can get better at it. But you have to actually listen to yourself. You have to actually watch yourself. You have to figure out what it is that you want to improve. That's the hard part.
Yeah, and study yourself.
Study yourself.
Mm-hmm. Your eating ass bit, by the way, is fucking hilarious. I don't know if you remember that one off the top of your head.
My God,
eating ass.
Yeah.
She has a video where she's like, when you see a guy and he just walks past you, and don't act like you didn't just eat my asshole. Like, it was just so, I was watching that on the way here and I could not fucking stop laughing.
Well, the thing was that when I did that one, it was actually like a joke, right?
It's a funny joke.
So my best friend, you know, she went through like a breakup or whatever, and she was just telling me, like, just imagine if I was. She's like, just imagine if I would say something crazy to him while he's with his new girlfriend. Like, if I see her, like, imagine if I say something crazy. I'm like, yeah, imagine you would say something like, don't act like I didn't eat your ass, you know, like. So it was something. It was just a joke, like really a joke, right? So when I put it up, I was just like, damn, I don't even know what people are going to think, but I think it's hilarious. Let me just put it up. Let me see what they think. Especially a girl that's pretty. It's not, you know.
Yeah. You don't expect her to talk about eating ass.
Yeah, you don't expect her. So I was just like, you know, basically saying, like, if your ex-boyfriend is walking around with his new girlfriend and he acts like he doesn't see you there, just say, like, don't forget that I ate your ass, you know? Just, like, something like that, right?
Wait, to say it, like, really matter-of-fact like that?
Yeah, like...
I ate your asshole.
Yeah, basically, like, as a matter of fact, I ate your ass. Like, just in front of her, just to see what the girl's reaction would be, you know? And I thought it would be a funny bit, like, if you actually would do that. Like, what would the other girl do? Like, so I put it up.
That's a college humor video.
And probably. It was to my surprise that people were like, oh my God, it's so funny because I kind of like did that to my boyfriend. And I was just like, well, that's an actual thing. All right.
Why? Well, no, I mean, it's definitely a thing to get back at your exes.
Yeah.
People are pissed at their exes.
That's a weird. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I've never been angry.
People will go to the grave mad at people that scorned them when they were 20. They'll hold it on forever.
That's true.
Why?
Kyle has maybe the greatest ex-girlfriend story I've ever heard in my fucking life.
Have I told this on the podcast?
No, you haven't. You fucking haven't. You wanna?
I think maybe. It's pretty funny.
It's long story.
So,
like, go ahead.
Did I tell you this, Jill?
It's so great. It's like a movie script. Oh, God.
It's pretty funny. Okay.
Let's hear it.
So, I was dating this girl. This is the last girl I dated before my wife, currently.
Yeah.
And they were actually friends. What's funny. Oh, that's me.
Fucking.
Sorry.
This is what we're doing right now?
Dude, I thought I...
Podcast 19.
Okay. So anyway, I dating this girl. Lived with her for like 2 years. Very pretty. Total, you know, had the weapon. She knew how to wield it.
Oh, are you going to say what her profession was?
Well, it's kind of important to the story. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay, maybe
fuck
not.
It. No, fuck it. Drop it. Who cares? Don't give her... Oh, just say it, dude.
Drop it.
Oh, fuck her. Come on, man.
All right. I feel like I'm being a dick.
You're not being a dick. It's hilarious. You don't think she laughs in the situation?
For the sake of the story. Yeah, she must.
Okay, so this is a story. She was pageant queen, okay? And she was a big country music fan.
Well, what state? She won Miss whatever.
She was Miss West Virginia.
I might Google her.
Yeah, and she was a big country music fan, and she went to a Kenny Chesney concert and didn't come back.
What?
That bitch up in love with Kenny Chesney.
I heard about it.
And this guy got a call.
No, listen. I heard about it the next day on my way to work. I heard about it on the radio. I was driving to work. And the radio story that was out is, and now the new news is that Kenny Chesney is currently dating Miss West Virginia and they're traveling the globe. And then it became this story that was picked up on like Us Weekly and all the tabloids, and I had to look at it every day and just think.
She didn't even tell him. She's up and left.
Yeah, she didn't tell me. We were living together.
So funny. Wow. Yeah, that's why they lived
she
together.
She had all her shit. Yeah. She had all her stuff is in my closet. We had our dog. God. We had a dog. And I'm just sitting at home, like going to walking my sad ass to like Walmart and like seeing like pictures of them making out in the cover of these magazines and everybody at work. Everybody at work, like, knowing what's going on and giving me one of these every time they see it. Hey, Kyle. How you doing? Yeah, it's...
I found her on Google. Do you want me to drop her?
No.
Okay. No. Right. look at his face.
So I was mad for a while. Like, really mad.
I would be pissed, too.
Yeah, I was fucking pissed. But, you know, at some point, I realized that, like, I had learned a very valuable lesson. And she didn't do anything wrong. She was doing what she thought was best for her. Fuck, this is like this big celebrity.
Yeah, man, if Katy Perry came to town and pulled your ass up on stage and wanted you in back, you'd go.
No, I wouldn't. Mel, okay. I wouldn't.
Not with Mel. I mean, with Kenny Chesney chick.
I wouldn't. I would never do that.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I would never do that.
Of course not. Mel's
genius. Never. I'm very happy with my marriage. Mm-hmm. I'm a very happy and satisfied man.
I'm happy for your marriage. I'd leave my girl for Katy Perry.
But, you know, there was no need being mad. I learned valuable lessons from that. That made me a better person. I learned how do I identify aspects of women that I definitely did not want to be interested in.
Women are people.
Yeah.
Women are people. Women are able to hurt you bad, too. Like, I really learned that. Like, they're able to do some serious damage.
I will never go to a Kenny Chesney concert.
No, a guy might... be able to like fuck you up physically. Women will wreck you emotionally.
Yeah, I'd much rather get into a fist fight.
I would much rather
be in an emotional combat.
Physically,
with
I can
you
heal.
Love.
You know, that was difficult. That was difficult water to traverse. Oh man, yeah, it wasn't easy.
Did she ever send you a text?
I love her. I love her for when it was good. You know, and for who she was. She's a great person for like when it was good. You know, there's nothing wrong with that.
Word.
I hope she's very happy, whatever she's doing.
That's good.
Tour bus she's on, I hope you're happy as can be. No, I'm sorry. Come on, that wasn't funny. That was a low blow.
No, but, I mean, you learn a lot through your exes and dating and stuff like that. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, if you do it right, only one works out. Mm. And all the rest don't.
It's true.
You know, I feel like maybe it's just me, but a lot of times when the relationships didn't work or something like that is because maybe deep down inside you knew there was something kind of wrong, like, but you wanted it to work, you know? So I think with relationships it's kind of like that, like,
or at least we're comfortable enough to stay there for a while.
In a lot of relationships you just want to impress other people with your relationship.
Yeah.
Like, one of the best parts about dating her was the fact she was a
Miss
beauty pageant.
Fucking West Virginia.
You see her right there? Yeah,
be like,
that's
me. Yeah, I'm that awesome. Yeah.
It is a status symbol.
I'm the shit. It was totally a confidence boost and a status symbol. Yeah, it was like having like a Lamborghini.
Do you feel like Oprah's husband feels like that, or do you think he feels like a bitch?
That's kind of a tricky one. Because he could be.
Yeah, to some dude that just sits. Like, you ever see Stedman? Photos of him?
Is this Stedman?
I don't know his fucking name. He's just some black dude that sits in the background.
They were together for like, they've been together for 20 plus years. Yeah. So that's crazy.
He just sits back there.
And the Oprah's pressure. Husband. Like,
I wonder if he's like an accountant or something.
Yeah, no, I don't think that would be that cool.
Mm-mm.
To be Oprah's husband. I don't think it works the same with guys as it does with girls.
You don't think so?
All right. Well, I mean, would you trade that in? You get access to like $1 billion, but you definitely can't fuck anybody else, and you have to fuck this old lady.
An old lady? It can't be like a hot chick just happens to be like a desire. No,
right. No, because there's only one like rich dude that's actually good looking. His name's Dan Bilzerian.
It's true. We were just talking about him before.
Motherfucker.
Dan fucking Bilzerian. It's so unfair. It's like the universe just sprinkled down every awesome. That's not fair.
Rich.
You can't be buff,
and
white.
Buff.
awesome, like have a jet and millions and millions of dollars.
Yeah.
He has everything.
Fuck that guy.
No, I'm good, sorry, for him. Good for you, Dan.
Dude, that's great.
You fucking nailed it.
Yeah.
That's funny.
And he was like an ex-Navy SEAL or some shit. Like you have.
Yeah, some.
It's not like he doesn't work hard or did.
Just got everything.
Everything. All of the things. Everything. I don't know.
Well.
Okay. Wait. Where were we going with this? Awesome. What? That was a hypothetical.
Yeah.
What would you rather? Would you rather be poor and good looking or married rich, but you can't fuck anybody else?
How poor are we talking?
Like you're level poor.
Oh,
like right now, level poor.
I'm good here.
You wouldn't trade for like $1 billion, but you gotta bang Oprah and you can't.
But I don't like Oprah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
I'm with you, dude. But I think a lot.
I'm pretty happy right now.
I think a higher percentage of women would take that trade.
Yeah, they would rather.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. Well,
would you?
I see it a lot.
Yeah,
so.
A lot of women would rather be rich with an old or ugly guy than with a handsome. Poor guy.
What do you think that is? You think that's social conditioning or biological?
Mel tells me every day that, you know, if I died, she'd just marry some like old rich guy with a lot of money.
She's not joking.
No, she's not.
No.
She's like, I would use him. I'd use him for every dime. I'd take all his money. I'd start an animal rescue.
She really likes.
At least
animals.
You put the money in good use, but that's cool.
Because women will probably think about it like this: I'm gonna date this guy that's old, right, and not attractive. And I'll take all his money and I marry him. And then I will bang the cute guy on the side and give him money.
I'll be the cute guy.
That's insidious.
Isn't that?
Obviously.
Well, it's bad because you're going into the relationship with bad intentions.
Yeah.
Is it bad
though? I'm such a simple.
This is the thing. I don't think it's bad.
Really?
No?
I don't. And I'll explain why. Listen, if you're an old, rich dude, You're not stupid.
You're on your way out the door.
Not only that, but you got to the position you're in, not because you're a dummy. You're fucking smart. You're old and you're rich as shit. Of course he knows his hot 22-year-old chick doesn't fucking love him. All he knows is that when I take this pill, I get a boner and I get to fuck that, and she can go off and do whatever she wants.
Mm-hmm.
You don't think this is an exchange? She's like, listen, I'll give you all this. This is young and awesome. Mm-hmm. You give me money. And he's like, yeah, and I get to bang you, and you can do whatever the fuck you want. You don't think this is an underlying agreement? Of course,
yeah,
I'm not
that,
saying.
Well, that was going. What was going on with that Clippers owner too? Right.
Right. Yeah.
Like he told.
That guy's
weird. He told his wife she could fuck other guys.
Yeah. He was kind of nice about it too.
For an old
racist white dude. You know, he's not that bad. He's like, listen, you could bang him.
You can
just
fuck
don't
him.
Post it on Instagram, please. Just don't post that photo, and we'll be okay.
Yeah.
She couldn't even.
He was like, don't. He told her she couldn't take pictures with black guys,
which is.
But weird. she could fuck them all she wanted.
That was
so
crazy.
Weird.
It was so weird.
Like, it's not that bad. Come on, he's not that.
That
racist.
Was a deal they made.
If he's letting her fuck him,
yeah,
it's not that racist, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's a very polite racist for an 80-year-old.
Yeah,
man.
You'd
think he'd be worse for being almost a century old, but he's not that bad.
Like the leader of the KKK is not like, listen, honey,
yeah,
you can fuck him.
He's probably like 45.
Don't take pictures.
It's not like that at all.
The fact that he even knows what Instagram is impressive in and of itself.
Pretty amazing.
So good job, Clippers owner, former
Clippers
owner.
Yeah, but I think you're right, dude. I think, you know, the guys know what they're getting into.
Of course, they're not dumb.
Yeah.
But the question is, like, do they know the extent? Do they know that girls are going in their relationship like, I'm totally just going to take all this dude's money?
They have to.
You think they care?
Sort.
I mean, they're pretty old.
Yeah.
You think they give a shit?
I don't know.
I'm not old or rich.
I'm just I can say I'm like the most simple girl ever. Like, I remember one of my boyfriends, they're like, you're just not, it's not that hard to date you. Like, cause I'm just,
I'm not believe that at all.
No,
are you still with him?
Honestly,
I don't believe that.
Are you still with him?
Nope.
He was crazy.
Then you might not have been that selfish.
Well, it wasn't my fault. Well,
just pretending that just, you know, in a pretend world where we're in a relationship, I'm terrified all the time. That's not, you're not simple.
I
no
am
way.
Pretty simple.
You get all that attention from being on Instagram.
Dating hot chicks is not simple.
Funny.
Ever. It's
fuck,
just not.
Which makes, like,
you know when you go out with your ex-boyfriend and whenever you went to a big crowd, did you ever squeeze your hand a little bit tighter?
That ever happened?
Mm-hmm.
Because I bet you it did, and you didn't even think about it.
Yep.
You know why? Because you're hot, and you're going to big groups of other men who are probably giants.
Yeah.
Just looking at you like steak, walking past fucking wolves.
You have to be on the lookout
all
the time.
Not something that's simple at
all.
Well,
it has to do with the guy. Well, it has to do with the girl too. Like, is she into that? You know, like, is she the type of girl that's like, oh yeah, yeah.
Are you?
No, I'm serious. Like, I'm so simple. Like. You know, sometimes guys are like, oh my God, I want to take you on like this huge date. And like, I want to make this magical. And it's just like, okay. Dude.
What a lame guy. I want to take you on a magical date. A big one. Really big one.
Big date.
Five courses.
Yeah.
No.
I'd rather just go.
Lame.
Take a walk and just.
About Taco Bell and weed, girl. What's up?
Yeah. I'd rather just get to know that person. Because it's a waste of time for me too. Like if I just. I'm dating you because you're hot, or I'm dating you because you have money, or I'm dating you because you have status. It's a waste of time because later on, I know how I am. And if I'm just dating you because of those things, I'm going to get bored rather than I get to know who you are and actually like you as a person and actually like to be around you.
So, wait, do you have a boyfriend now?
No.
You're not in a relationship?
No.
How's it going so far?
It's going.
I'm serious.
Well, it's going
like,
well.
Do you go on dates regularly?
No.
No?
I could, but no.
But you're like, no.
No.
Singing and stuff?
I'm just trying to focus on myself. Like, I
broke up. You know that's a cliche.
No, but that's the truth. Because it's like, I was in a relationship for 5 years.
Oh, it's a long time.
From 19 to...
Almost now.
To almost now. Yeah, so I was in a relationship for 5 years, and I was really, like, all about my boyfriend. I wasn't looking, I was really about that. But for me, I lost myself in the relationship and I needed to find out who I am. So it doesn't make sense for me to break up with someone and then jump into a relationship with someone else, because the whole sense of like losing who I am, it's going to happen again. So it's like, what was the point of me being single? So I'm just trying to really focus on myself. No jokes.
Is that where that Prisoner of Love song comes from? Is that where that comes from?
When I was in a relationship. Okay.
Prisoner of Love?
That's on her sound. You didn't listen to her music. On her SoundCloud.
No, I didn't.
Yeah.
I just listened to the comedy.
She has a song called Prisoner of Love. I listened to it on the way here. Pretty really? Good. Pretty fucking good.
Thank you.
I don't even like that genre of music. It's good.
Thank you.
It's
thank awesome. You.
I don't get music that well. I mean, I have a terrible taste in music.
He does.
Terrible.
He has the taste of a 13-year-old girl.
I do.
And right. I'm not making fun of him.
My favorite artist right now.
Katy Perry?
Pitbull. Katy Perry.
Kesha. Nicki I know you Minaj. Like Kesha.
Nicki Minaj is cool.
Yeah, Kesha.
Yeah.
Pitbull's cool
Iggy
too.
Iggy Azalea. Lord.
All the high
top. Top 40, bro.
Yeah, the top. All
right. You know what? You and a millions of other people, so
I
it's not that weird.
I was never able to develop that sort of emotional connection that people have with music. Yeah. I watch other people enjoying music. I'm like, wow, look how much they're enjoying
Every time I try to get this guy to a concert with me, he's like,
you're like, man, no.
Why?
He's like, I wanted to go see the Misfits with him, and I showed him Misfit videos. He's like,
why?
Because he just saw like crowds of people smashing into each other. He's like, not for nothing. This music kind of sucks.
All right. Well, like, I think about it like this.
What are you talking about?
The point of music to me is to like change your state, right? Like to get you to feel something, right? And if like the Misfits, that just makes me feel annoyed. Like it's just a bunch of whining.
Oh, it's not nice.
It's
fair enough.
But that's what it sounds like. I'm just being honest. I'm just being, I'm giving you a peek into my own brain. And it, to me, it just sounds annoying. It sounds like whining. It makes me feel annoyed. Wow. You know, that's the state. But when I listen to like some dubstep, like new remix that's loud and has a progressive ramp up or something like that, it'll just set me off. I'll feel great.
It's true.
So to me, like it's all about the feeling. Maybe you guys can help, you know, explain music.
Well, I'm not a singer. How did you get connected to music then? Like, was it the church traditionally, or how was it all that stuff?
No,
I'm always humming, dude.
Everybody, a lot of people start in church, man. It's not a weird question.
Well, I'm always humming. I'm always like, I don't know. I'm when I'm in that state of, I guess, tranquility. I'm just thinking. Coming up with
zen.
Stuff
is the Tao.
Yeah, I'm just
the
like,
flow,
and it just comes out like
flow state.
Yeah, it's just in the flow state where I'm not thinking of anything, but most of the time it's experience, like from my personal experience, what's been going on with me. You know, I'll just try to put that in my music. And one thing that I want to be is honest to myself, even with my comedy bits on Instagram.
I think that's I want to be honest. That's all anybody wants.
Yeah, because, you know, if I'm honest, if you find that honest part of you, you're going to know that people are going to automatically relate, because even though we're different, we're not all that different. Even though no one's the same, you know, well, we still going, go through the same emotions.
We're all on this ride together.
Yeah.
And nobody knows what the fuck the ride is.
Yeah.
Which is one thing that we all share.
Sure. It also helps that you have a good voice. That also kind of helps what you're singing.
Yeah, thank you. thank you. I mean, I love singing. So I'm kind of glad that I have my own place and, like, no roommates, just me by myself. Because I can see how people could probably get annoyed, because I'll just be, like, washing my dishes and I'm all of a sudden I'm Beyonce. I'm like, oh, I'm a single lettuce. Oh, I'm just, like, washing my dishes. I feel like I'm hanging shoulder. Like, I just get into that and just, I could be completely annoying.
I feel like that song should have an alternate ending where, like, the other music video is just, like, a lady crying, washing dishes.
Oh, the single lettuce.
Just, like, that gets just really sad.
Oh.
Like, just really like sad.
Hanging out with her cats.
Yeah, just
washing
like,
dishes.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much. I'm just so happy being single.
Right.
So, how about those protests, huh?
Cops killing people. Did you go? Who went to the protests yesterday?
I didn't.
Yeah, no, none of us did. Fuck all that shit.
Yeah.
I don't like going into giant crowds of angry people.
People
ever.
Are pissed.
Anything can happen.
Yeah, no, like, they were shooting, I don't know, we were talking about it before the show started. Cops were shooting sound guns, whatever that means, into crowds of people. Just,
I think,
nauseous or something.
Well, and just for reference for everybody, because this might not be on for a few weeks, the people that are protesting the, what was the guy's name that got choked out?
There's the Ferguson thing and the Eric.
I forgot.
We'll go to the internet.
Yeah, the guy selling loose cigarettes that got choked out by the NYPD and died.
Yeah. I mean.
And so that guy didn't get charged, right? So that's why people are out there in the streets right now.
Yeah, well, he didn't get indicted at all. No, they got off clean charge. So what happened was, for those of you who don't know, in Staten Island, there was a guy selling Lucy's on the corner. Eric Garner is his name.
Eric Garner.
They say it was because he was selling Lucy's, but what happened was he just stopped a fight that happened between two people, and he broke them up, right? And then the cops came, and then they started talking to him because they've seen in the past that he was selling Lucy's, so the cops already knew him. And they were like, well, what are you doing here, and blah, blah, blah. And got into an altercation to where, like, six cops just jumped on a guy for no reason.
For no apparent
To arrest him, I guess is what they were trying to do. And in the process of trying to arrest him, one of them put him in a chokehold, and he was a really heavy-set guy, and that eventually, during the chokehold, he went to cardiac arrest and had a heart attack and died. And people up in a, and, you know, like, obviously they didn't mean to kill him, but after the fact, no one tried to revive him. The paramedics didn't try to revive him. No one did anything right.
Yeah.
And, you know,
I think the paramedic got there and was like, I think you guys killed him.
They're like, yep, he's dead. Like, no one tried. Like, no defibrillator, no chest compressions. So they basically just murdered the guy. And now people are pretty upset.
It's funny because it's not funny, but it was basically a snuff film.
It was all on video.
You can watch it on YouTube right now.
Yeah.
Just a man getting murdered.
And it's crazy because it's crazy because it's your kids probably will go online and watch it.
For sure.
Yeah, and they're going to think that's fucking insane.
Yeah, your kids.
They're going to go back and see that and be like, holy shit.
Yeah.
Dad, you lived through that? Mm-hmm. That happened?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, me and you walk around all the time and, like, I physically get nervous around cops. I do not like being around police officers at all. Just freaks me. You know what I'm talking about, JL. That shit it's uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And you're just like, why are you good? Like,
yeah. Well, because I've never had to.
You never had to?
Yeah. I just walk around. I'm like, hey, fellow white men, how are you in your crew cuts today?
It's a weird.
You know? I've never had to experience it.
Yeah.
Well, you had it done.
Well, didn't you get? You had a pretty bad situation with the cops before.
Yeah, but you should have seen the leeway these guys give me. Like, I'll get drunk as fuck, like puking all over the place, just swinging at imaginary people, and like the white cops will just be like, "Oh, don't worry, he's just drunk. I know what he's doing. I know what's going on. He's fine." And I'll keep that up for like hours until they just tire out and they're like, "All right, we gotta arrest him."
Fair enough.
Seriously.
And I don't necessarily think
it's
because
too much leeway.
I don't think it's like geese cops are inherently racist or anything. Like people, like some.
I think it's a power trip.
It's a power trip too. And also, I don't think you should be sending in cops who are not used to a certain culture into a fucking neighborhood of people they don't know how this culture works at all. Because most of the time they're not from there. So why would you send that guy in there? He's gonna be nervous as shit. He's gonna be holding out. Like it's just scary for him in the first place. Like why wouldn't you send a cop, let's say, from that neighborhood into that neighborhood to deal with certain situations? Because they'd be way more receptive, way more than the guy not from there.
Yeah.
It just doesn't make sense.
And there's stupid laws.
Yeah.
Just the fact that you put a police officer in the situation where he's the cop looked like he was like very scared.
Oh, in the Eric Garner video?
Yeah. Well, I mean, he looked terrified that you would put a cop in a scary situation with a giant man that you don't know what he's capable of. Like, let's be fair. Like,
he's a big human.
Big dude. Mm-hmm. To put a police officer or another human in that situation where they may feel like they have to fight for their life, or they may feel like if I don't use deadly force against this guy, I might die.
Yeah, but
it's justified, that might have been going through his head because he's like a little tiny. Did you see how little the guy was?
The guy
he's
was tiny. Little, but the thing is, like, the guy was like, I can't breathe. Like, I can't breathe. Right. At least like they should respect that. You know, okay,
but we shouldn't put anybody in that situation anyway over loose cigarette laws.
Yeah, I mean, I just feel like
it's ridiculous.
I just feel like
the law shouldn't even be there.
I mean, there was a friend of mine, actually. I was really pissed at this. She's a girl. She swiped her card she was just coming out of work. And
Metro, like Subway?
Yeah, she swiped her card. Yeah, I'm sorry. So she went on the subway, she swiped her Metro card, and she's waiting for the train. The train is approaching, and a cop is like, I saw what you did. And she's like, what are you talking about? And he's like, you hopped the train. And she's like, no, I didn't. I swiped my card. Like, why would I? And he used force because she didn't want to. She was like, I didn't do anything wrong. And she's a pretty girl. And he used force. And he arrested her.
What?
And
what
she was there.
Was this?
This was probably like it was like probably at 1 o'clock in the morning.
She black?
Yeah.
Cool.
She's black.
Me and my brother hopped, we hopped the subway
turnstile.
Yeah. And cop saw us and he was like, hey, did you guys hop the turnstile? And we were like, yeah.
Have a nice day.
And he goes, what's your name? I was like, Kyle Fields. He goes, all right. And that's it. Then he walked away.
Yeah.
Weird, right?
Yeah, no.
That's the white privilege.
Hop turnstiles.
That's what they're talking about, right? When people tell me to check my privilege.
Yeah. Well, those people are also douchebaggy most of the time. Usually.
I did check my privilege. There's an app to check.
There's an app for that.
Is there? Does it help?
Yes. I have quite a privilege. It's pretty high.
You ever been stopped in Frisch Jail? Yeah, you too? All right.
Stop and frisk.
Yeah. That's a motherfucker.
It's always pretty cold in here, right? Or is it me?
This jacket, yeah. If you want.
Can we turn up the heat a little bit?
Mm-hmm. Definitely. But
yeah, a little bit.
But yeah, no, I remember when I got stopped. I was like 14 years old, but I hopped the train, and the cop he had like a Lakers jersey on, and he was like this black cop, and he had like this.
He was undercover.
Yeah, he was undercover. He's like, he shows me his badge, and I'm like, me no speak English.
No habla.
No hablo inglés. And then I was.
Yeah,
I was cool after that.
For those who come to New York, it's always the guy just standing in a corner with a sports jersey on and shorts.
Yeah.
If he's just standing there looking at turnstiles, that's a cop. Just so you know, that's a fucking cop.
Mm-hmm. There's got to be a lot of undercover cops down the subway, huh?
There's a fuckload, but they're always obvious as fuck. It's always cargo shorts and a sports jersey.
I've never played the game of try to spot the undercover cop.
But I'm pretty sure there's cops that are just like, not today, dude. And they'll just look at you and just like, you know what? Today, I just don't want to approach you.
How do we get the cops back on our side? How do we do that?
You know what it is? Here's the thing. You have the same type of people being in charge of the same type of people. So it's like, at the end of the day, it's a person that goes through an ego trip.
Do you mean you have people from the neighborhood become the police officers for that neighborhood?
Yeah, like, or, you know, you have, like, anywhere, you have these bad seeds. Yeah. You know, and there's some people that are bad seeds that are like, hey, if I'm a cop, I could get away with so much. Or, you know, and yeah, maybe.
And that job draws in those people.
Yeah.
It pulls people that love power, love to be in control. I feel bad for the good cops. Attracted. There are good cops out there.
I feel bad for the good cops because, you know, they're the ones that probably come home and they're just like, these fucking cops, you know, like we're trying. And it's like every job, there's some jobs where people don't want to do their jobs. And there's some jobs where, and there's some people that do want to do their jobs and do take their jobs serious. It's like,
and you're gonna get pretty cynical over time being a police officer. Yeah. Like when people are constantly lying to you, they're lying to you all the time.
Yeah, I mean, a huge part of a cop's day, good guy or not, is you're gonna get shit on. No one wants to be around you.
Yeah.
No one wants to make eye contact with you. And when you do have to deal with people, more oftentimes than not, you could be in danger. Like, it's a scary job to be in.
And you can snap.
So, right. And if you're always in a heightened sense of just paranoia, it's like, I feel like it's like a on a it's like a lower level of being a soldier every fucking day.
Yeah.
Like, it's not quite as extreme, but a lower level.
And there's an us versus them thing that happens. There's a line that happens where it's like, clearly I'm on this side, you guys are on that side, and it's us versus you.
And there've been cops where they've just been like, you know, they do catcalls.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's cops that are like, hey, girls, come here.
Really?
It's like, that's happened to me.
They're still humans.
They're not robots. Maybe we should have robot cops.
No, and then...
Skynet, Kyle. Skynet.
And then iRobot happens, and then we need Will Smith to help us.
Did you see all did you see all the tweets this week about really smart people being very scared about artificial intelligence?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stephen Hawking came out and said, listen, like, he got new software for his chair. You know who I'm talking about? The guy who, like, So he got this new software for his chair and for his voice. Mm. The software basically and very accurately guesses what he wants to say. So it actually thinks, like, and it gets smarter and it gets to know him and it predicts, like, his next action. And apparently it's creepy enough that Stephen Hawking was like, you got to shut this shit down.
Yeah, no.
Like, it's so good.
I think it was 4 weeks ago, Google released, information. Like, hey, guys, we made a self-programming computer.
Yeah.
It programs itself.
Right.
So it's, like, ever-evolving. It's writing its own code. So it could just, I got a problem. I'm going to fix myself real quick.
I'm
going
to fix myself. That's and then it gets better. And then it fixes itself better. And then it fixes itself better. And then it fixes, and it's exponential. It's going to keep fixing itself.
I was talking to a bunch of trainers at the gym. They're like, I don't like any of this. You know, eventually there's a potential for it to take us all out. And I was like, guys, yeah, probably. That's probably the next evolutionary step, to get rid of humans. You know, not for nothing. Like, what was that quote? That humans are just the sexual organs of robots?
Of the machine world.
And that makes sense. It's like,
Marshall McLuhan.
This thing is, no matter what, this is far more optimal than me. This thing right here.
Have you guys seen the movie Idiocracy?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And all, you know, there's some truth to that, too. The people that are having kids are dumb as fuck.
Yeah.
And the people that are well educated and realize... They realize the full impact of having kids. They tend not to have kids.
Mm-hmm. Scary as fuck to have kids.
Yeah, because it's scary as fuck to have kids.
It's true. That's true.
So there's people definitely just a like, devolution.
I never understood that. Effect. Just people who just like, and then just pop out kids. Like, there's no
there's
like repercussions.
There's a huge responsibility.
It's like, you just need a fucking human. That's a $300,000 money hole for at least 18 years.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
It does seem like humans we're not doing a very good job. So maybe it's time for robots to take
over. I praise the robot overlord. I hail you, robot overlord.
Oh yeah.
Dude, take over my life.
Mind of the robots.
If that AI turns on and it's like, listen.
I'll work for it.
Either become my slave or you're annihilated. I'm like, I'm
slave.
Slave. What do you want me to do?
Do I get a gold chain?
Yep. I'll wear the collar. You want me to wear a collar? All right. Cool. I'm in.
Let's do it.
Do whatever you say.
Whatever.
I'd be the first to do it. But like Elon Musk, he's tweeting about it.
Which one's that?
He's the Tesla
smart guy. Is that?
He's the Tesla guy, and they're all very scared. It's weird. Once you turn it on, there's no going back. Once you drop the bomb.
I have to say, I feel like technology has made me stupider. Like,
think so?
I do.
Why?
I hate reading now. It's just like, just tell me.
Yeah, but who says reading makes you smarter?
I don't know.
Reading doesn't make you
smarter. Do you think you learn it all from the videos you watch? Unless you're just watching.
I'm more of a visual person.
Right.
Yeah, I don't like reading anymore. But I used to read the Harry Harry Potter books. I used to be like that nerd, like this, like, oh my God, it's such a good book, you know?
Think how much more you can learn on YouTube than you can from reading
books. It's true.
Books.
Yeah, this is, I don't.
Fuck books.
I don't understand. Like, there's a weird prestigious, like, you know, I'm in school and I'm right now, I'm like a literature major. So there's a lot of kids who are just like, yo, so I was reading, you know, Ray Bradbury the other day. Like, these kids that are really into fucking reading.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yeah, I've almost never sat down and read a whole book. I'm like, yeah, I just listen to podcasts and audiobooks. And they look at me like, I'm fucking crazy. Like, I'm the asshole. I'm like, at one point, reading was just the best way to get a point across. Well, why would I
use your imagination, too.
Totes my goats. Why not just watch an awesome video of someone doing it for me? Yeah. Like, why not visually just learn? Like, isn't this more effective? Like, I learn way more from videos and audiobooks than I ever will. Like, I can't just sit and look at small text where I need to get my glasses now because this is old. When I have it on my computer, read it to me. Come on.
Yeah.
Like, why is that less cool?
How long does it take to read a standard size book?
Like 200 pages, 300 pages? Right.
Maybe. Probably
how long? But how long does that take?
Yeah, no, 8 hours, 2 days.
Okay, 8 hours. Imagine watching 8 hours of TED Talks.
Yeah.
What are you going to learn in 8 hours of TED Talks? What are you going to learn in 8 hours of reading?
But I just feel like everything will get, like, if someone's talking or explaining things too much, you're going to be like, all right, get to the point. To the point where you're just like, just inject it in my brain. Yeah. I just don't want to hear it anymore.
Yeah, well, what if we could? Like Matrix style. I know Kung Fu. Right? Like that moment where you just download, and it's like, now I'm a kung fu master.
Exactly.
If you could do that, wouldn't you do that?
I think that's what we're getting at. I think that's what people want. Like, just inject it in my brain and I got it.
I think it's probably way better too for your profession, being a singer, because if it was like, let's say 2,000 years ago and you were, you know, in Oxford, if you had to read how to sing better, you wouldn't be as good as you are. I'm sure you've watched 1,001 vocal lesson videos on YouTube, maybe.
No,
I'm
guessing. Or I just take lessons. Or it's just natural.
NBD.
Maybe it's just natural. No, but I think that we're just getting there. Like, just get to the fucking point. Now it's like, especially Vine, it's like if the comedy doesn't get you in 6 seconds, there's no point.
Is that how long Vines are?
Six seconds. That's it.
Six seconds.
Dude, me and you have made 1,001 Vines. How do you not know?
Yeah.
I just forget because the feels like ancient history.
Yeah.
Honestly, we were into Vine before Instagram had videos.
Yeah, we
and then
loved
once
Vine.
Instagram had videos and they had 15 seconds.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't think Instagram videos are on par.
It's funny
Vine got too culty. I didn't like that. Mm. It got like culty with the Vine famous, like that whole Vine famous thing that happened.
Yeah, like that Jerome Jure guy now.
There's some funny people.
Yeah,
hilarious for him. Are you on Vine?
Who is he?
Jerome.
I am on Vine, but...
Are you? Do you post in there at all?
I only have like one video because I'm just like 6 seconds.
I feel like you'd
seconds.
Be effective.
I know. I don't know. I tried it.
It's not your cup of tea. You need the Insta. You need the 15.
I don't, maybe. I'm
there's more
sure.
people on Instagram too. Vine's going to be dead.
You're dead. No,
Vine. Are you defending Vine?
Yeah.
Are you kind of upset?
No, I'm just being a contrarian.
But it'll be dead, right?
Yeah, probably. Like,
me. It'll be Facebook. It'll be MySpace.
It's owned by Twitter, though, so I don't know if I'll ever truly be dead.
Twitter
owns Vine.
You know what's so funny? I don't get Twitter at all.
I just figured out Twitter this week.
I got really stoned yesterday.
I got super high, and I figured out how to use it.
Let Kyle explain, because now he knows.
This is what Twitter is. It's a big party. It's a big bar.
Really?
Where you can talk to anybody you want.
So maybe I should just get drunk.
A bar, you can approach somebody and start up a conversation. Your pickup line better be pretty good. Or, you know, you better be a good person to talk to. But you can basically talk to anybody. You just have to, you know, do it virtually through your phone. And you can kind of get in on other conversations. And the key is it's the interaction. I used to just get on it and think, I have to post something witty or post something smart. That's not like the fun part. The fun part is like getting in on people that are already talking about something.
Dude, how cool
is
it?
It's like brainless, like maybe a brainless conversation.
It's like what we're doing, but you have to type it out. And it's slower, you know?
I suck at it.
But more people.
I'm not a great conversationalist, actually.
That's why you're on a podcast.
Yeah. That's why you're here.
I'm not a great conversation.
You've been talking for 53 minutes.
I think
straight.
You're pretty good.
I know, and I have like major anxiety.
Are you freaking
like,
out
I
right
was
now?
Just talking to my
How do you
friend.
Feel right now?
Be honest.
Super anxiety. I am super anxiety right now.
Is it
really?
Because of my looks?
Yeah. It's like, because you guys are both so attractive.
Well, yeah.
Me.
Happens a lot.
All the time. Why?
Yeah, what I'm are you afraid of?
You're a singer. Don't you get on stage? What is that? Because there are a lot of people who are super like anxious, who are performers. Like, why did you get on stage then? Mm. You're like, I'm super nervous. I should probably get up there.
I don't know. I guess I like to push myself. Like, if I'm scared of something, I like to really go.
Yeah, conquer it. Mm-hmm. Challenges. Mm-hmm. I get it. Like, I would love to do stand-up. I'd love to. I dream of it. I think about it every day. I'm terrified of the idea of standing up there by myself with the spotlight on me in front of people. It's like the scariest idea ever. I'd rather run away from a bear. I'd rather bike away from a bear. Like we saw. Did you see that video, by the way?
Which one, you ADD fool?
Sorry. God damn it.
But yeah.
Well, now I'm terrified. About it.
Oh yeah, there's this bear attack.
Dude, pull it up.
Pull this shit up. This is insane.
Right. Oh god, we have to get someone. Else to get mauled.
Type in GoPro bear attack.
Oh shit, America.
But yeah, I suck at conversations.
No, you don't. Mm-hmm.
No, you're doing a great job.
No, like if somebody will text me.
Yes.
You're at a solid B plus.
That's
right
the one. That's the one.
Yeah.
Solid B plus, 87%.
All right.
It's awesome. Good.
Watch this
passing
one.
Grade.
And tell me that your palms don't get sweaty.
On
wait,
a
turn
GoPro.
Turn the volume up. No, it's after it's over, I guess.
JL does not want to promote this bullshit on our show.
Fuck
thank you,
this.
JL.
Dude, do you think that's a YouTube studio that you were talking about?
Yep. The one that we're trying to get into? Yeah.
All about that bass.
No travel.
I remember seeing this commercial when I was high the other day, and I was like, this is hilarious.
You know what's my
favorite
commercial?
HP. Do not buy HP.
Yes.
The Hot Pockets commercial. Okay. Hot Pockets, Hot Pockets.
Let's talk about this here in a second.
Fucking love
watch
it.
This shit.
Oh, God, I'm so nervous already. My hands are sweaty. Oh, shit, run, man, run.
Oh, fuck.
Are you sure he's not CGI'd?
Oh, my God. Don't look back, you stupid motherfucker. Just go.
I want to.
Oh, it's so big, Kyle.
Oh.
That is crazy.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
Oh, my.
That bear's hungry, dude.
That's an old bear.
That bear wants a meal.
Dude, you just keep going. Oh, my God. It's
is he that fast?
This is like Jurassic Park.
Flying freaking Fred.
Oh, fuck.
Is he really
oh,
that
my
fast?
Hands are sweating.
Oh, God.
Oh, bike, man, bike.
Dude,
hell
pick
no.
It up.
Hell
dude,
no.
Dude, you were so scared you'd
hell
fall.
No.
God, it's
hell
still there.
No.
It's coming after him, man. That
why?
Bear is hungry as
no.
Fuck.
Hungry. It's,
bear stole
oh, my God.
Oh, it's a stick.
Oh.
Get off that bike. You run,
no.
Motherfucker. Get up a tree.
Is he
why are you getting
running?
Off the bike?
No.
Why are you stopping?
Is he gonna? Is this real? Is this real? This is not real.
That's a fucking bear.
Nah, he's CGI.
I feel like we should be quiet. I know it can't hear us.
Is it fake?
Quiet.
It has to be.
That's
fake.
Real, dude.
No. We're gonna check it out.
That's 100% not CGI. Why are you moving, bruh? They got good ears. Oh, my God.
You
think
no.
It's fake?
I think it's fake.
I don't think so.
Maybe not. But that's I think
up.
It's fake.
Oh, my God.
Did you guys ever hear about the guy from Animal Planet or something like that?
Snopes that. Can you Snopes that? I'm sorry, go ahead.
That he loved bears and stuff.
Grizzly Man.
Grizzly Man, he ended up being killed by a bear?
Yeah.
A dumbass.
Oh my God, that was so crazy.
That guy is a sad case of just come out the closet.
It was like,
yeah.
I love
just come
bears. Yeah, it was.
He hated himself and had a fake girlfriend and hid in the woods and then
he,
ate a
and
bear.
They would tell him, stay eaten. Far away from the bears, but he'll go and he'll pet them. This is Joe.
This is Billy.
This is Joe. This is Billy.
He's
you know,
die,
like, it was like it was really weird. And then when they come, I guess to see like what he's up to, it's only his bones. Like they skin him.
They ate him and his girl.
Yeah.
His quote unquote girlfriend.
He really thought he was a bear.
Oh God. All right, here we go.
Is it real?
Is this GoPro bear attack fake, awesome, and or fake and awesome? Pretty thrilling YouTube video.
Why would you get off the bike? Just pick it up over the thing and. Mm. I mean,
it's a fraud.
I knew
it's fraud. False.
Motherfucker!
I
got
it.
So scared watching
it's
that video.
It's my first time watching it. I knew it.
Oh.
I knew it.
That's a terrifying video, though.
Because he was like running super, super fast.
Bears, no, bears run fast.
They do, but.
I think they can.
Way faster than you think.
Run pretty fast.
Yeah,
pull up a video of a bear sprinting.
Really?
It's way faster than you think.
And I think that bears don't attack unless they feel like they have to. Attack.
If it's an old hungry bear, like old grizzlies, they'll eat your face. That's what killed the guy we were talking about. What's his name?
Yeah,
Bearman,
but he was
whatever.
Too close. I think that no. Joe was tired of him. I think Joe was like, you know what? Get the fuck out of my face. And now I'm gonna eat you.
For sure. But if you watch the doc,
you know what?
It was a bear that was supposed to be hibernating that ate him. And it wasn't hibernating because it was starving. It was an old bear. They found the bear. They found the one that ate him.
and they
What is this?
This is a bear sprinting.
He's not that fast. He's not faster than a bike.
Hey, man, this is zoomed far in.
Yeah, he's already tired.
We don't have reference.
Oh, wait.
I can't outrun a bike.
I don't know. That bear's moving.
You gotta remember how zoomed in. I don't know. I can't tell here.
Because you're not on a road. You're biking trail with rocks and shit. Like, it's not smooth.
Yeah, pretty good about that.
Mm-hmm. You know what the fakest thing about that video was? How convenient that branch was, like, placed right across.
It was too perfect.
It was a little too perfect. Yeah. And they're showing
Scorsese
some videos.
Made it.
Kudos for me.
They're showing some videos of...
I want to believe still.
Just believe.
It makes me happy that guy got away.
Yeah.
I wish you got eaten.
Whoa. Strong words.
Right.
I don't. You're just on a trail.
For faking that video.
Oh, for fake. Okay.
Yeah. That's what you get.
Get eaten.
What if you got eaten next week? I feel so bad.
You would.
I don't want you to get
eaten. You're putting it out in the universe, so maybe.
I changed my mind. I don't want you to get eaten. Don't get eaten.
Not how the universe works, Kyle.
Yeah. So.
What else is? What were we talking about before? Anxiety. Yeah, anxiety. Why?
Anxiety.
So you're a performer. Yeah. Do you get nervous on stage still?
I don't know. No, not really. Not really. I mean, sometimes.
So just talking one-on-one with people.
Yeah, talking to people. Like, even texting, I'm just very bad at, like, holding conversations. So yesterday, my best friend, she was like, you should come to this party. And then I started asking her questions, like, who's going to be there? And, you know, and she's like, why are you asking all these questions? I'm like, because I'm trying to be a better conversationalist. And I'm starting with the people that I love. And she started laughing because she's just like, you know, she knows I'm just that one word person. They'll be like, oh, where do you want to meet? I'll be like, there. There where, Sasha? Awesome. Like, I'm just that person that'll just be like, one word.
Well, this would be good practice for when you're super famous.
Yeah.
Remember us.
Yeah.
What tips do you have, Alec, for conversations?
Honesty. That's it. Just
one?
Just be honest. Well, I mean, if you're honest, people are going to end up asking you a lot of questions. Like, if you're really 100% honest during a conversation, you're going to say weird shit because you like weird shit. Everyone here likes weird shit that they don't talk about openly. But if you're honest, people are like, why do you like that weird thing? And it kind of just flows. You just keep going. Just don't lie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just don't lie ever. Unless you have to.
Yeah. When I would meet people, I'll just lie. You know, because I'm not.
I used to do that too.
Yeah,
I still do that from time to time.
Mm-hmm. One Brazil,
I for sure lie.
I'll just make up a lie. Like, there was this lady, she was like, I was moving out.
I could teach kung fu. Sorry.
Yeah, I was moving out and she was like being nice and she was like, and I bought this big luggage. And she's like, oh, so you're going on vacation? I'm like, yeah. I'm going on vacation. But I'm, like, moving out of, like, my boyfriend's apartment. I'm like, I'm going on vacation. She's like, where?
Depression.
And now you have to make
depression a location.
Now you have to make it deeper. Like, you have to dig
where?
More.
I'm like, you know, just, she's like, Puerto Rico. I'm like, yeah, Puerto Rico. She's like, because you're Puerto Rican. And I'm like, yeah, she's just making the conversation easy for me. I'm like, I'm so Puerto Rican. You know, but I was like, yeah, because I was.
Sometimes
just, like,
it's easier. You know, you just feel like it's just easier not to
or
tell
like
you
if
the
someone's
truth.
Like, yes.
Or maybe it's somebody you just don't want to tell the truth. Maybe it's somebody you don't want to be authentic and honest with.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to bring them in.
Pretty much. It's like
somebody you don't want to bring into your life.
In that inner sanctum.
I felt like that before.
I just say yes to everything. Yeah. Like, oh, did you watch this? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Did you like it? Yeah. I just say yeah to everything.
Yeah. How often?
Did you hear about this? Yeah.
When somebody's like, did you see that movie or some movie that you know you should have saw and you can see how important it is to the person that's about to ask you? And you're like, yeah.
Yeah, it was good.
I did. And inside you're like, you didn't see that movie at all.
Yeah.
And you just like, do a quick Google, like,
it happens with me the most when, like, people will say a joke and everyone starts laughing and I'm like, ah, I get it.
Don't get the joke.
I don't know the reference. I never read that thing or whatever the fuck you're talking about.
Yeah, we all probably lie a lot every day. Even, like, the little white lies. I should really count them.
Yeah. When people say, Sasha, do you work out? I'm like, yeah. I don't. I've never worked out.
Really?
No. Yeah.
At all?
No.
No hoisting?
Never.
Nothing?
Mm-mm.
I don't believe you.
I'm serious.
You
did you play sports in college? I mean,
no.
Baseball?
No.
All right.
You better get
I asked for a bike. I asked my dad for a bike. He never bought it for me. And that was like...
And that was your attempt at exercise. And you were like, well,
yeah.
Didn't work. So I guess it's not in the stars for me.
Yeah, basically. So no.
But you've never worked out? Like yoga, spin class?
No, nothing.
Very spooky. I like,
dancing.
No. Well...
Class.
I dance in front of the mirror a lot.
Okay. Well...
Squats.
No, I'm getting into it...
Hip-hop abs.
Now, but no.
Fuck. Nothing?
Nothing.
You gotta get started.
Yeah.
I am gonna get started now.
Are you?
No.
I don't believe you.
I'm not. Okay. Well, maybe.
You're gonna regret that. One day.
Not now.
It'll be like 38. You'll be like, I wish I'd been working out.
No, but I am... Like I said, I'm becoming an adult. So I am understanding how to eat better and how to, you know, what's good, what's not good. Because I used to eat McDonald's all the time and take out foods all the time. And now I'm just learning how to cook. And that's why I'm really...
Something about the 20s that make it very difficult to see the future.
Yeah.
It's really easy to focus on where you're at in the 20s because everything's so awesome.
It's new. It's still
like
fresh.
You're awesome. You're young.
We're good.
You're
hot. This is the best it's going to get for us right now. It's going to get worse tomorrow. That's it. This is the best right now.
But that's why I'm taking the time to be single and really get to know me as a person.
Does that... Smart. What is it?
No, it's smart. Yeah, I get that. I think most adultery happens because people didn't have enough experience while they were...
with other people.
While they were single.
You got to sling it.
You got to sling it. You got to
sling it until you ming it.
Sling the V.
You got to try every different type of...
Throw it out there.
Yeah.
Throw it against the wall.
Slinging the V.
Sling it until you ming it, I guess.
That's a hashtag.
It is. For this episode.
Slinging the V.
Sling that V.
Hey, how do you feel about slut shaming? I'm trying to wrap my head around that one.
I
get it, but...
I don't
want to slut shame anybody.
I won't, me neither. It's I don't know.
I don't know what the rules are to not slut shame somebody. What am I allowed to say?
What do you think?
You know what?
We have a woman on here. I need to know the rules of conduct because I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. I don't want to make anybody feel bad.
Right.
About being promiscuous. I think being promiscuous is probably a really smart thing to do. I think it probably benefits your life quite a bit. I think it's the way that we're designed to operate anyway. So
it's funny because it'll be sluts that'll shame sluts.
Really?
Most of the time. Because I just feel like if you're a promiscuous person, there's nothing you should be ashamed of. That's who you are. You know, like this is... I mean, I don't think there's anything to be ashamed of. And I think it's a moral thing. You know, like,
well,
if you're okay...
Well, sex is bad in our society.
It's not.
It's not.
And that's the thing that, like, kind of pisses me off.
You said sluts same shots. Sluts, right? Shots. What makes someone a slut, then?
I think...
No, seriously.
Calling someone a slut. I don't know. Because I just feel like if you're mindlessly, I guess, fucking people, I guess...
I am a slut.
Like, you're just like, I'm just going to put my dick in it, or I'm just going to fuck this guy. You know, I guess you can call that.
But is that bad?
You know, I don't know. I can't even say.
See?
Because
it's still working on her.
It's getting all of us.
Yeah. It gets all of us.
Yeah, I don't think.
We think it's bad. We don't think a massage is bad, but we think sex is bad.
Yeah, massage on the penis is bad. Massage on the back wood.
I don't think
it's... Both make you feel
good. Sex is bad. I don't think sex is bad. Because... At the end of the day, everybody fucking watches porn. Women watch porn.
Everybody watches porn.
Everyone watches porn. Yeah. So for you to say that sex is bad, it's
the only people
so
in jail don't.
What's up?
The only people that don't watch porn are the ones that haven't seen how good porn is now. It's fucking...
It's pretty great.
It's pretty good. And it's everywhere. And, I mean, your only shot is to avoid it altogether. Because once you know what you're missing out on...
Yeah, but I don't know. I think people just talk.
It's true.
I know a lot of friends that are very promiscuous and have had over 100.
Yeah.
I know people, and I will never look at that person and be like, oh, look at you, because they know what they're putting themselves into. Now, if you don't know what you're putting yourself into and you're just like doing it, I guess, just because you think it's cool or you think it's whatever... I mean, you just, I don't know. It's more
really,
of a moral
thing. It's a recklessness thing.
It's maybe a reckless...
It's like you could get pregnant. You could get an STD. You could get beat up or raped, you know, if you put yourself in a bad situation with a bad person.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a you're putting yourself in a sensitive situation. You could fall in love with somebody who doesn't love you. You know, there's a lot of bad things that can go wrong in sex, right?
Yeah, I think it's the recklessness. I don't think it's slut shaming. I just be like, you're just being reckless. You're just being reckless. Instead of being like, oh, you're a slut, just say, you're being reckless, dude.
Well, I know a lot of guys, though, that would never marry a girl that's had sex with more than like five people.
Yeah,
I have clients that like, they brought this up. They would never marry a girl that had sex with more than five people.
Which makes no sense to me.
Why?
Because why?
First off, five is okay.
Five is the number, magic number.
But 50 is bad?
And also, why would you want to have, like, come on, man. Someone who's had sex with, like, two people, they're not very good at it.
Yeah, they're not going to be very good at it.
Why would you ever want to have sex with someone? Like,
they watch porn.
Those dudes are like, oh, yeah, I want a virgin. Why? Why would you ever want a virgin ever? Because that just doesn't seem fun at all. It just doesn't even make sense for sex.
I think it's more of a, what do you feel?
Domination thing.
Mm-hmm. Like, there's a weird purity aspect to making sure your
woman
has...
What's a trophy thing, too?
Mm-hmm.
I'm the only one.
Less dicks in her.
I'm the only one that knows.
That's so stupid.
You know? Same shit as the women that wear the beekeeper outfits in the Middle East.
Oh, dude.
It's the same thing, because they're like, I'm the only one that knows what she looks like.
Oh, dude. Oh, my God.
No one else knows. Beekeeper. I am the only one.
To all three of our Middle Eastern listeners, I am sorry. We have none.
Is that bad?
It's fun.
Is that insensitive?
A little bit, but whatever.
But it looks
the face mask, I know, at least called a burqa. I know that much.
Yeah. But you know what?
Is that bad?
I actually went to high school with...
I'm sorry if I hurt anybody's feelings. I didn't mean to.
No, I know. It's funny.
I actually went to high school with a girl that the only thing you could see were her eyes.
Yeah.
I went to high school with her.
Never saw her face.
I think there was so much pressure. Because we're like, we just want to see your face. We just want to see
if
you're
beautiful.
Oh,
she let you.
So she ended up just, I think, senior year, just coming.
Did God smite her?
Was it like Raiders of the Lost Ark?
It
saw
was
her
a
face.
Choice.
Like everyone's face melted.
No, everyone was like, oh, okay, you're pretty. Okay, she was pretty. But it was so funny because she was always telling me about, like, a guy she would date. You know, like, she was always dating a new guy or whatever. And you're like, how the fuck did this happen?
You think she just said that to kind of fit in, though? Because I'm pretty sure those girls in that traditional setup oftentimes have an arranged marriage. Like, I have a neighbor who, they're from the Middle East. They're from Pakistan. You know, live in America. Mm-hmm. They were, like, the girls in the family would wear, like, the traditional garb. But, you know, as soon as one of them graduated college, they sent her back to Pakistan. She married some dude she never met in her life.
Really?
Just married him. Yep. Still, like, a part of the... I don't know if it's a part of the religion, but I think it's mostly cultural. But, yeah, it's just, like, it's weird. It's, I don't understand.
It's weird.
The youngest one, sticky. Totally.
You think that's going to be around in 20 years?
Yes.
I think you'll still be doing
it'll be less.
50?
It'll be less. Less. Still be around, though. I give it 200.
200
yes.
years?
200 years.
Maybe.
See, that's the thing. I don't want to say for them to be modern.
Do you remember
what
was going on 200 years ago?
No, I wasn't alive.
Well, I mean, in the history books?
Not really.
Nothing. Nothing was going on. They didn't. They barely had watches.
Yeah.
Wow.
They could barely tell time. A watch meant that... No, shoes were a big piece of technology. Like, we have pretty awesome technology now. Like, back then, if you had shoes... Baller. Baller.
You see Jimmy in his new shoes?
He has shoes.
That's pretty interesting.
And a watch. He knows what time it is all the time.
Yeah, but that's still a really prevalent thing, slut shaming in our culture. It's really strong still.
Slut shaming.
I think it's mostly religious, right? Puritan, like it's like a Puritan idea of.
It's religious, it's culture, it's all that stuff. Like my uncle, he's from Spain, right?
Neat.
He's from Spain, so he's just like, you know, he's always ranting on like. Americans have got no, they have no culture. Like always.
We don't. Only been here a couple hundred years.
Yeah, so he would like take me to Spain and show me all these cathedrals. Like he took me to Spain when I was like 12 and he'll show us like all these cathedrals and stuff like that. And I'm like looking at it like, who fucking cares, right?
Yeah.
At the time.
This is a long fucking, these were dumbass people.
Yeah, so I was like, who fucking cares? But now I see the appreciation for that. You know?
Really?
Yeah, and now I appreciate it more.
What is it?
Because it's like, you know, it was a different...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It was different.
It's different.
Everything was so
when
different.
When I say dumbass people, like, I don't mean it bad. And if I was there, I'd be dumb as fuck. Like, yeah. I'd be extra dumb.
To answer your question before, 200 years ago, this country was 29 years old.
Yeah.
Mm. Brand new, baby. Still young and hot.
Cool.
Crazy shit. How about, I read the other day, until 1901, they had a black person in the Bronx Zoo.
Yeah, they had two people from Africa.
In the zoo. In the zoo.
Are you serious?
Until 100%.
1901.
That was not that long ago.
How about this? How about this, humdinger? It's still illegal to be gay in most states. In 40% of the states, still illegal to be. You can't marry either, gay people.
Really?
40% of the states. It's less than 50% now, which 40%? Is great. But still, like 40% of the states can't marry same-sex person. Because religion.
That's so silly.
Because religion, yeah.
It's so funny.
It's so weird. That's still a fucking thing that no one talks about. Like, yeah, we're just not going to let that happen for a while. Oh. Why do you give a shit?
It is silly. It's funny.
It's like the ultimate.
But it's also the first time that we can look back and see ourselves in the past right now. Mm-hmm. Like, you can go to certain places in the Midwest and be like, oh, it's 1995. Yeah. You know, you can actually turn around and be like, right now they're going through what we went through 15 years ago or 20 years ago.
Yeah, it's crazy because growing up here, I didn't know what racism was. Like, in the Bronx, I didn't know what it was. I was just like, really? You know, yeah, I didn't. I was just like, yeah, it exists. Right, you know? Then my cousin, she went to school in Georgia, and she was on the bus. She was talking Spanish, and the bus driver stopped, and he was like, you are going to speak English on this bus. If not, I'm going to kick you out.
She's in college age?
No. Jesus. She was like 15.
Oh, is a school bus?
Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
School bus.
Weird. Have you ever toured before, like with your music?
No, not yet.
I was going to ask if you ever experienced racism with that.
No.
I think our kids aren't going to really understand it.
But it's like when I go down south, I am either, I'm just black and white. I'm not Spanish. Unless when I...
There's a line. Yeah. And you're either white or everything else.
Yeah. So I'm like, they're like, oh, you know. And all of a sudden I look like everyone that's like black and white on TV. They're like, oh, you look like Alicia Keys.
Yeah, you look like everyone that's not white.
You look like Halle Berry. I'm like, when? Where? Where is she? Yeah. Like, I wish. Like, it was so weird.
It's still strong, man.
And they'll be like, you know who you look like, right? I'm like,
I think we're all going to blend together. Doesn't matter. Yeah. We're like two or three generations away from just all of us being this mixed race.
Yeah. It's still like you know, being in New York, you get diluted. But like when I went back to Vegas not too long ago, you know, so I went to high school there. Like, you're either Mexican, so I'm Mexican when I go there, or Middle Eastern. I'm Middle Eastern when I do this.
Right.
Or like, I still have friends there that are like, who are my age? I remember he said this. He goes, yeah, that one chick, that one black chick in that movie is really hot. I'm like, yeah, she's super hot. She's yeah, but you know, she's only hot because she has white traits. I'm like, what is it? What is white? Like, he's like, she's only hot because she has white people characteristics, but she's
hot.
What
the heck? That's so weird. Yeah, like, I don't get that.
Conversation.
I don't get that. You see, I don't get that. Here in New York City, we're a melting pot. You know, it's like,
this is in Vegas. This is a city of 2 million.
Yeah, but look, there's ugly people. I'm just like, there are ugly people out there.
No, for sure.
Right? That guy was probably just very confused.
I think he's just dumb.
He was just associated, like, he had a fucked up association.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Where his association was that if you had attractive traits, that meant you had white traits.
Right. That's why it's so stupid.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's just fucked up in his perception.
He's all right. He's a nice guy. Just didn't meet.
He just didn't, yeah, he was just uninformed.
Mm-hmm. You know who you are. Sorry.
But yeah, it's weird. Like, I never got that.
Yeah.
So weird.
Man, that's what makes it weird to watch these Ferguson videos.
Mm-hmm.
And be like, people are fucking pissed and they're on the streets. And it's that bad. And the cops are wearing army outfits and they have AK-47s with helmets and masks.
Don't they have?
I don't know. I'm just assuming.
They have sound guns.
I'm assuming they have like big guns. Like, they're not going to be walking around with some like little
pistol thing.
Minky pistol. They're going to have a big fucking gun. Be intimidating, right?
Yeah, cops have tanks now. You're on that? Subsidiaries, what? Military subsidiaries go to cops now. Cops have like I saw it in New York once. It was so fucking crazy. I was walking down the street and driving down the road was this military vehicle. It just had in New York? Yeah, it was driving on the highway.
Why?
Had NYPD plastic. I think they were transporting it somewhere. Like, it was no particular event, but it was fucking massive, and it had like 6 tires. It looked like it was just like steel plated, like that. It was the biggest fucking vehicle I've ever seen.
Wow.
And it was like it was for sure made for the military, but it had NYD slapped on the side, and they were taking it. They're probably taking it to like a factory or where they store it or something.
That's crazy.
It was fucking huge. Like, that's something they just have.
That's weird.
Because cops need tanks.
I think it's all gonna get better because of all this media attention.
I hope so.
It'll cause something. People will be aware of it, just like the Occupy Wall Street movement, where it didn't really do anything. They didn't like change any laws, but they got an idea into people's heads.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the idea of the 1%, the idea that there's a very few amount of people in this country that control most of the resources, most of the money, most of the control.
It's true.
And that stuck around. That changed, you know, people's perception over the last, I mean, how long ago was that? 4 years ago?
I think so.
It's definitely affected
culture. It causes people to say, you know, like, I have to make a difference, you know?
Yeah.
And
people are now aware that cops can do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're aware that those cops could fucking kill you, even if you're not doing anything wrong.
Exactly.
Does stuff like this like affect your music at all? Like, do you find stuff like this will just influence anything you write or sing about?
It does. It does. It really does. It does. Because it just comes from an honest place, and the honest place is that this is where I am, or like this is where I grew up, or this is what I'm seeing, and just seeing this guy, like, really in the snuff film, it really pisses me off.
Garner, Eric Garner.
Yeah. Eric Garner. It's a snuff film. It really pisses me off. So there's no way you can watch it and as a human being not feel something. And from that comes truth. And from that, you know, you write about it. You talk about it. You feel it. So.
I get kind of sad sometimes too when I think this probably happens a lot. Like this Eric Garner situation.
You know what?
It's got a lot of publicity, but then there's probably shit tons of other cases across the country that just didn't happen to get picked up and blown up into media attention. Like, I read this story about this home invasion where they threw a flash grenade into a crib and they killed a baby.
Oh my God.
Like, no, you guys didn't even hear about it, right? You would think that something like that would be front page news across the entire country. Police force throw flash grenade into crib and blow up baby.
That's horrible.
But nobody's ever heard of it.
No.
Like, that sounds on par with the Eric Garner thing.
No, I'm sad.
Yeah,
right?
No, it's true. And then I have a friend that she grew up in New Orleans.
Nice.
And she's black. And my friend was like, do you feel any way about this? She was like, I grew up in New Orleans. She's like, and I see this all the time. All the time. This is happening all the time. You know? And
nobody was talking about those cases.
And no, exactly. That's what she's saying. Like, it happens all the time. And I look at her and she's the most positive person I've ever. Because, you know, she's like, you know, I've seen it happen to my family. You know, I've seen it happen. You know, things have happened to me. And she's like, I have a choice. You know, do I get angry and get even, or do I try to live a positive life? And she's the most positive person ever.
Yeah.
And it's crazy because it's like, you can't help but to get angry. But once you get angry, you don't want to not stop being angry.
Yeah, like people are out there stopping traffic.
Yeah.
They're so angry. They just want somebody to piss off.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, to what you were just saying, being happy when I mean, I think the most potent or effective speakers and like stuff, I guess, have always been relatively happy and calm and always approach the situation way better than you want to instinctively. Like, I think it's pretty much why like people like Martin Luther are pretty effective.
Yeah.
Like, I've never seen a video where that guy was like, motherfucker. Like,
and he stabbed
and shot. But like he had every right to be like, fucking white people. Like, he really could have. And he never did. He was like always.
And the person that stabbed him, I think, was an African-American or black.
What did he do that for?
I think it was a woman or something. I don't know who it was. Maybe I might be wrong, you know. But he got stabbed. And he was still like, don't worry, I'll be fine. Like,
is that your Martin Luther impression?
Yeah. I'm pretty
for sure do that more.
Like, yeah. But it was, it is strong, people. Like, because there are so many fucked up things in the world that happen. But there's so many amazing and beautiful things in the world that happen.
I think there's a lot more beautiful things, too.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Fuck, it's probably even.
No, I think so.
I think it's even. Or maybe
it's balanced.
It's whatever you want to be, man. Like, if you really want to be right. sad every day,
you can. You can
like,
find it.
How many people?
Illuminati will definitely, like, you go on YouTube and look up Illuminati.
One.
And
that's
that
the
will,
magical one.
That
people
will
get
keep
crazy.
You home all
like,
day.
Like, Beyonce's in the
Lumen.
Beyonce's.
Yeah. Did you see what she did? Like, shut the
how,
fuck up.
Like, I bet you, all of your parents or grandparents, someone in your family is constantly watching Fox. And she's like, did you see? It's always something sad, especially my grandmother, my poor grandma. I love her to bits. But she's, you know, she stays home. She's a Puerto Rican lady. And she's constantly sending me these text messages. Alec, mijo, please stay away from the protests. I love you. Cops hate us. Bye. Like, stuff like that. Like, she's so scared because all she does is sit and watch news all day. And she's in a constant state of panic. Whereas I feel like I'm always I'm on constantly Reddit uplifting news and I'm generally pretty happy.
Yeah.
That's like, so I think whatever you want it to be, it can be that. But I think statistically it can be shown that most of the world, things have calmed down a fuckload. There are way less murders globally than there ever have been ever.
Yeah.
I think statistically we can show that.
I think your brain gets a drug whenever you spot something dangerous.
Yeah.
Like just like if we lived in a village and there was only 100 of us, and I was out on the outskirts, and I spotted a grizzly bear. And I ran back, and I told everybody, there's a grizzly bear out there. We got to be ready. Yeah. And everybody got ready, and
there's a reward
system
in that.
Avoided the danger. I would feel really good. Yeah. I saved the village. I did something really great. And I think people still can get addicted to that drug today, where that they fixate in part of their brain. And I watched a TED Talk where there's a particular part of your brain that just goes crazy at danger, whenever you spot danger. So you get this weird rush of spotting something dangerous, and people just get stuck in that cycle.
That's true.
Of constantly looking for danger. It's like a drug.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they need their danger fix.
The danger fix, yeah.
Just named you a new song.
There you go.
Right there. The danger
Boom.
Fix.
You're welcome.
Might
no
be
big
a hit
deal.
Song.
By the way, we need a new name for this podcast.
Yeah.
What
we
are
do.
We call
iTunes,
it?
iTunes took it down.
Because we had mushrooms in our name.
Because the name was Meathead on Mushrooms.
I say we just make the name M.O.M.
Mom.
Meathead on Mushrooms.
Oh, Mom.
Mom.
Sounds pretty cool.
I don't know. Probably not talk about Maybe. It on the show.
I don't know. Maybe we just call it the podcast. Think that name's taken?
No. What do you think? You're way more creative than both of us, for sure. What do you think?
The podcast. I don't
Prisoner
know.
Of Love? How about that?
We'll just call it the pod.
Podcast of Love. No.
Just like parents that don't know what to name their kid, we'll just call it like the podcast until we figure it out.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Done.
Okay.
Okay.
Sold.
The super cool.
Good one.
The super cool.
That's it. That has a good ring to it. Super
Incredible.
Cool podcast.
The super cool podcast.
Right.
Talk about everything.
Cooler than you podcast.
Uh-oh.
The Fuck You podcast.
Okay.
I don't know. I
think we're officially out of topics. I think we're officially
I went for attention grabber. Yeah. Feminism.
You want to name the podcast Feminism?
The Feminist. The Feminist.
It's so bad.
Oh, no.
The Femcast.
The Fem... Mm. Yeah.
No. Feminism. No, but Feminism. I got on a rant yesterday. I couldn't understand it. I think I kind of do now, but this is where I'm having trouble. Like 60 years ago, predominantly, like no women went to work, and the only jobs that women had were like secretary positions, nursing positions. There's like 8 jobs.
It's a bad man
that like 10% of women could do. Now.
We can do anything.
There's going to be a woman. There's likely going to be a woman president next.
Soon. Clinton?
Very
Hillary?
Likely. I mean, it's very likely. They do every single job that men do. They do.
Can't do any sperm.
No,
you know what it is? Women are more insecure than men.
I
think so.
This is where I don't understand. It seems like victory has happened. You won. Like you got it all. Women, you can do it. Like you're at the very edge of finishing. Will this, like, will feminism, ever, like,
but
how
we
much
haven't
more,
finished yet.
How much further do you gotta go? Really? No, I'm serious.
I think there are just
like,
a
we
few.
Just have
considering
to,
how far it's come.
Well, it's definitely made progress, for sure.
Made progress?
Yeah.
Dude, they wouldn't believe the shit that's going on in the 60s. If you would show them how women have integrated and made themselves just as valuable to men in almost every aspect of our society, they wouldn't even believe it.
Yeah. I think there's a future. I mean, like things like most, like I think it's mostly in the South. I can't name most of the states off the top of my head, but for sure there are states where women are not allowed to get an abortion, or like they have.
That's
to,
pretty fucked
like there's
up.
Things like that where you can't control bodily functions that's on the basis of just being of having a vagina by virtue of having like you can't do, and that's by definition just like oh yeah, you're not as good as us.
I just feel like that's a women issue, meaning like. Guys shouldn't even have a say.
Yeah, like, why are you even thinking about...
Like, there should be no men it's involved so in any sort of policy around that issue.
The only person that should involve is the person who got you pregnant, you, and you handle your business.
Mm-hmm.
Finn. I think it's up
to her. Yeah, why does the government have to be involved in...
I just think any men. I mean, if the government's going to be involved, only women should have any sort of say.
Mm-hmm.
I really feel that way. I mean, it's just like, it would... Imagine if a whole bunch of women got to say how we got to use our penis.
Yeah.
You'd be like, fuck off, women. And you don't even have a penis.
It's my penis.
It's my penis.
It's, you know what? And it stems from religion a lot of time in these southern states because more often times than not, it's the guys who are like, well, it's a life from blah, 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 and the Lord Jesus. Like, and that's fine. You could be religious and think that. But the moment that your views on the galaxy and being religion interferes with, let's say, an atheist's life or just any person's life, you're now an asshole.
Yeah,
and you just happen to be in a position of power, or you happen to be a city council or governor or whatever it may be, and that's bullshit. You can't force your dogma on anyone's bodily functions, and I think that's one of the big issues that feminists have now.
It's probably the biggest, right?
I would think, abortion,
and you said work.
Oh yeah, they get like 80 cents to every dollar that men make. I think right now.
Oh. Compensation.
We want a dollar, and we want it now.
We want the full dollar.
Wait, what is that about?
Well, I got the, it's my dick, and I want to fuck now from...
Boogie Nights.
Boogie Nights, yeah.
Awesome.
See my name in lights.
That's one of the greatest movies of all
it's
time.
It's so good. It's such a
it
good
really
movie. Now you have to
like
watch
I just lied and laughed at you guys?
Yeah. It's such a good movie. I'm going to be something, Mom. I'm going to be somebody.
This movie sounds terrible.
Dude, it's
yeah,
so
he becomes
good.
Like this huge porn star.
It's about John Holmes and his giant dick.
Who the fuck's John Holmes?
He has a dick the size of a baby arm.
Does he really?
Yeah.
There's some impressive dicks out there now.
No, he's dead. But
why is it that dicks have gotten
dick
bigger?
The size of a baby arm.
Let's talk about that. Old porn, dicks
evolution.
Weren't that big.
It's
right now?
It's evolution.
It's not about the size. Well,
there's more people in porn.
Really?
Now.
Is it not about the size?
It can't be too small.
Something's coming at you
it
with 3 inches of thunder.
It can't be a micro penis. It just cannot be a micro penis.
Not about the size. It has to be at least 6 inches. Otherwise... Every girl's not about the size. Well, you
it can't be a micro penis.
It is about the size.
It can't be a micro
penis.
No, because if it's too huge, I don't want...
If a girl had a huge vagina, that would be an issue.
It's about the size.
Exactly.
Really, this is a giant vagina.
Yeah.
I can't even feel it. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
so
I don't
if,
like
imagine
it. I don't
a
have
girl,
a giant penis. I can't have a giant vagina.
Yeah.
It's just not going to work.
No. It's just no. Like, I remember I was, like, watching porn, and I stumbled upon some guy just, like, fisting. Like
that
and you
shit
see her
makes me
like,
uncomfortable.
It does, and I just want to talk about it briefly because I don't want to talk about this again. But he
just threw it
fisted
in
her with this huge
with his arm,
fucking condom or whatever glove
on the hand,
and he fisted her, and you can see it through her stomach.
He's making like a puppet show with her stomach.
Like, yeah, he could have made her stomach
just the dancing.
He could
in there
make her whoa stomach talk if he wanted to. Like, hey, I am in here. But it was really bad, and that's it.
What type of porn do you watch, brah? Why
exactly
is that,
see,
that's
why I don't want to talk about it. No, I'm just kidding. It's just, it just happened. It
some
was
people
just
are
like,
into fisting.
You know when you get in that I'm porn not hole, you're 38 yeah, tabs like, open, and you wake up from your orgasm, and you're like, what happened to me? Oh, God. Like, you were in a trance, and you just, and you look like, why are there midgets fucking
in
my screen?
Trance.
Like, you just like, how did I get here?
It's weird.
It's like being teleported
as
there.
As soon as you're done, you snap in, you're like, what happened? Yeah.
Like,
and
the walls are covered in blood
like,
in your apartment. You're just like, what's going on?
How did I get here? This is terrible.
You know, I'm a bad human.
And that's the thing. Women are not honest about it. So that's women. They're not honest
dude,
about
no
it.
No one's honest
it's
because
they're not allowed.
It.
They're slut
shaming. Yeah, but they're like,
men
no,
aren't honest about
watch,
it.
I don't watch porn.
Did you guys... I have to bring this up. We're talking about porn. Did you guys see that in the UK,
there is a giant list that was just released 2 days ago on things that are forever, not forever, but that are currently banned in porn in the UK.
Why is the UK so pissed about porn?
They're weirdos.
Okay, all of a sudden?
Female ejaculation, banned. No
really?
Squirting.
No.
Girl, yes, you can't, no more choking. No more choking. No more smacking.
But what if the girl likes to be choked?
Doesn't matter. It's illegal. It's illegal in sex. It's illegal in the porn now.
All right, hold on.
Wow.
Well, when you say illegal,
as in porn, like you can do it in your home,
they're
obviously.
They're going to do it.
No, like in the recording of porn in the UK.
No. But they're going to do it in the US and they're going to see it in the UK.
By the internet, right. But,
so who
but
cares?
Porn made there can't have any of these things.
Okay.
So it's shutting
who
down a whole.
Who makes porn in the UK?
I'm sure there's an industry.
Fuck. No.
The
no
point
way.
Really? There's no porn made?
No. What I'm saying is like all the people from the UK probably come to the US, make the porn,
maybe.
And then ship it back to.
Right.
Well, but wasn't
didn't
UK
have to ship
really
it back,
big on
just
porn?
Just put it online.
Once?
Yeah, but was that?
Wasn't UK really big on porn once?
I don't know.
I think they everyone always. But like the point is like that's fucking stupid. And by the guy who made the list, by the way, of all the items to be banned, is now being arrested for child porn right now.
Oh yeah,
he's going to jail
that.
For child
okay.
porn.
Yeah.
The
child
dude
porn
who made
good.
The fucking list.
Okay.
Yeah,
it's.
Well, wait, did it pass? Is it actually
yes,
like
it's
a law?
Now. It's law. Yeah,
I'm gonna look this up.
Go to the Reddit train.
Also, you should look up right.
Google.
Supposedly, you could look up like dumb. Illegal things. Like, supposedly, women, it's illegal for a woman to ride a man while having sex.
Where?
Supposedly. I don't know. I was watching
states.
It on, yeah, in some states.
That's
yeah.
hilarious.
Have you watched it?
No.
But in some states,
that's great,
it's
though.
Illegal. Like, if that
is it
happens,
one of those old
and
laws?
You call the cops, you know, like, the girl could be arrested.
Like one of those old laws that people just,
yeah,
they
never bothered. They never bothered
they
to change it. They're like, well, I mean, we could. Well, who wants
come on,
to?
Who doesn't like that? It's like it's one of those old textbooks that no one's seen in 30 years.
Yeah.
It's so weird because haven't they figured out that this method of just trying to block people from doing something they want to do
doesn't work.
Mm-hmm. It just makes people more pissed and then they just do it harder.
Yeah.
And then they fight
they
back
do
harder.
It harder.
Harder.
Yeah.
They do it harder.
It's funny because sex.
It's funny because we're talking about sex. But yeah, they push back more. It never works out in the regulators' favor. Mm. Why are we such terrible lawmakers as humans?
I don't know.
We suck at that.
Dude,
we do. We
do
suck
put
at
anyone,
a lot of things.
Even with ourselves. You put yourself in a giant position of power for whatever happens.
Hell
there
yeah.
is a mental shift
hell yeah. hell
in
yeah.
everybody.
Hell
they
yeah.
did a study with kids, little school kids, and they said, they literally divided up into two groups. Like, they played like jail. You're the guards, you're the inmates. That's all they said to these kids. All they said.
That's really bad.
These are children. Automatically, the guards started abusing the prisoners.
Other groups. That was a real study too.
That's what I'm saying.
Right.
Why would I make it up? They were just abusing the shit out of the prisoners. Like, but why would a kid know how to do that? Any position of power anyone's in, they're just like, I just need to control.
Yeah, power's not good.
Not good.
Yeah, they did this. They did this actual test where they had this prison, this fake prison. And they hired these guys, like, you know, guinea pigs or whatever. And they got the worst people to be the guards. You know, like this guy that he obviously is a dick. And he's like, okay, you're going to be a guard. And then this guy who was, like, pretty smart, you're going to be a prisoner. And it just shows the contrast of, like, as soon as you're giving a title, what are you going to do with it? What type of power are you going to do with it?
I would love to see that Craigslist ad. Looking for assholes for potential study.
But it was really bad. It was really bad. I think the scientist or the guy who put the test together, I think he got arrested. Because it was really bad. Because they were physically, like, beating these guys.
Oh,
and they were not even real guards. They weren't even... I forgot the name of the movie. There's actually a movie with it. Mm-hmm. And I'm really bad with names. But the guy who starred in piano...
Started in piano.
What's his name?
Kyle's good with the stuff.
Adrian Brody. No? The piano?
I don't know.
I thought it was Adrian Brody.
I don't know. I'm bad.
Is it called
with
The
name.
Piano?
Yeah.
The piano. Whatever.
To the internet.
Yeah. So he was in that movie, and it was just like, I couldn't even watch it.
Oh, maybe.
It.
No.
Like, I could watch scary movies, but I can't watch things that are like.
Holly Hunter?
Harvey Keitel?
Harvey Keitel.
Really bad name.
Who was I thinking? The fuck?
You said Adrian
Brody.
I've been smoking way too much weed.
Yeah. But it's really what you do with power.
Yeah, fuck that shit.
I don't think anybody's good at it. Like, name one person that has a shit ton of power that's being awesome with that power.
Dalai Lama?
It's funny because you have to.
What power does that guy have?
A bunch of Tibetan people
wants,
still.
If that guy wants to affect my life, how the fuck could he do it?
Well, not yours, but Tibetan people.
How many are them? Like 11? There's not a lot of Tibetan people. They got taken over by China.
I know.
They kicked them all out or killed them. Honestly, there's not a lot of them.
Yeah, there is a lot. They just moved to Pakistan and shit like that. In India.
How many Tibetans are there?
There's at least 300,000.
I bet there's 13.
God damn it, Kyle.
Have you guys seen the movie Gandhi?
No.
Oh, my God.
I heard he was a dick, though.
Isn't it 6 hours?
It's a pretty long movie. I just caught the beginning, but it was pretty good. It was pretty interesting.
Inspire you?
A little bit. It was pretty interesting how, like, there was a moment where, because Indian people didn't have any rights, I think, in South Africa or somewhere in Africa.
South Africa?
I think it was South Africa. And even if you were rich, like you couldn't even, if you were a rich Indian guy, you couldn't even, like, you had to sit in coach or whatever. In the beginning of the movie, it shows Gandhi as a lawyer. He's sitting in first class or whatever. Mm-hmm. And they're like, you have to sit in coach or whatever. And he's like, well, I'm not going to do it.
Because I'm assuming paid for the.
Yeah, he's class. Like, you don't understand. I am a lawyer. You can't do this to me. They kicked him out. Like, they kicked him out.
Was this during the apartheid?
I'm not sure. I think so. And it was crazy. It was really crazy because there was one moment where, like, they're beating him. And he just kept on, like,
being Gandhi.
Being Gandhi. And didn't even, like, fight back or anything. Ugh. It's crazy.
That guy just, like, he figured something out.
Yeah, he did. He did. It was weird. Like, without violence, they kept beating him. And he was still, like, with no violence, just, like.
That's a powerful thing to watch.
It's pretty powerful.
Watch somebody getting beat up and just taking it and just not fighting back, not responding. That's a powerful person.
That is very
you watch
powerful.
That and you're like, wow, that guy is the powerful person in this situation.
Yeah.
It's powerful pussy.
You almost said pussy. We all thought, we were like, Kyle. Freudian slip there. What do you want? What are you watching over there on that laptop, bro? What are you looking at?
Don't worry about it, man.
Oh my God. That's a powerful.
Hashtag power pussy. Hashtag.
Oh my God. I'm getting hot.
Oh, fuck. All right. We got to end this thing.
Oh, that was awesome.
It's been a great talking to you.
Sarah, where can people find you?
Well, you can find me on Instagram. So it's Sasha Merci with an I. And www.sashamercy.com.
Yeah.
And
SoundCloud.
You're right. Sasha Merci.
Sasha Merci. All right.
Get up on it, bitches.